Okay, so we are continuing back for the previous part. Figure 4.1 show the external view of the heart. So this is the heart. Use the align to label C to identify coronary artery. Okay, so you can see that actually this is the coronary artery from the picture that I found, and it's at the vein here, the artery. And of course this question is not in the textbook, if I'm not mistaken. The reason is sometimes the question asked not in the textbook. It's probably like this lah. In exam, usually got 100 questions. 1-2 questions that make it extremely difficult. So among 100 questions, there will be one question that will be extremely difficult, and it might not come in the textbook. So they purposely do like that lah. Huh? Maybe don't want to let the student get 100, or to distinguish the very very smart student. So it's common lah, among all exam, even in mathematics, BM, science, there will be one question or 2-3 question that is extremely difficult that usually student cannot do, but they still get A, but even the A student cannot do. So we can distinguish the student. The heart rate increase during exercise because the blood flow quickly. So this is a 3-mark question, and the student only get 1 mark because he just say oxygen increase. So where are the another 2 mark? So we can see that this is from the marking scheme. So of course we teacher we mark, we just follow the marking scheme lah. So more oxygen glucose to be taken by the muscle, this is mentioned by the student. The second marking scheme, more energy can be released. So I cannot see any word is referring to energy, so the student didn't get this mark. Correct reference to respiration, this one can correct reference to respiration, this one can give correct, okay, because assuming that more oxygen and glucose to the muscle lah, BOD lah, benefit of a doubt, but can lah. The carbon dioxide can be removed. Okay, so I just maybe give this student 2 mark. Okay, so explain why the heart rate increase. Exercise makes the heart beat faster. So inhale of oxygen, more oxygen go close to the muscle. Okay, the explanation of this student is okay, but not that good. Why? The question asks, explain why the heart rate increase. So usually I will start with this one. You can see even the masking game that provide money. Why the heart rate increase? Because when we exercise, there much respiration to be taken, where the muscle need more oxygen in order to do the physical exercise. So you can see when I say the muscle need more oxygen, I get the 1 mark. So that more energy to be released. Okay. Usually I will just say this lah. Because the muscle need more oxygen. So in order to get more oxygen, the heart beat fast and the person respire faster, breathing increase. So that it will increase the intake of oxygen, and carbon dioxide also can be removed from the body. So this one more systematic, the explanation. Like why heart rate increase? Because the muscle need more oxygen. So in order to need more oxygen, the heart need to pump more. When the heart pump more oxygen, the intake of oxygen increase. The intake of oxygen increase, the decrease of carbon dioxide also remove quite a lot. So it's systematically rather than the heart beat fast. Okay, the heart beat fast is the second or third explanation. Hormone can be transported in blood plasma. Define hormone. So he get 1 mark. The reason is the keyword is gland, is underlined in the marking scheme. So when it's underlined means it's important lah. So chemical substance produced by gland. So the student didn't say gland, so they didn't get 1 mark. Which alter the activity of one specific target organ. Correct. Okay. For example, so the student will just get 1 mark. Another mark is here. And name the hormone that causes the increase, adrenaline. For example, we can see adrenaline causes the heart rate target to specific organs such as the heart. Of course, we have a lot more hormones that target specific organ. Yeah, so insulin is a hormone, so which organ it target? So the major target organ for insulin is the liver. Very good. Sodium reacts with water to form aqueous sodium hydroxide and a OH and a hydrogen gas. This is an exothermic reaction. Okay, so heat is released, energy is being released. So it's an exothermic reaction. Label the energy diagram to show reactant, product, and activation energy. The student only get one mark because the activation energy is correct. He draw the arrow. Reactant is correct. Product, the student should just write like this, product, rather than going down. It's not supposed to go down, right? It's just like activation going up. This is the reactant and this is the product, not going down. So the student just get one mark for this question. During this reaction, the sodium melt. Maybe it's too hot, is it? So it melt. Describe in terms of particle what happened when the sodium melt. Okay, so of course why it melt, the keyword is kinetic energy increase. More energy is given, so the energy of kinetic energy increase and vibrate strong enough to overcome the attractive forces between particle. So because the student didn't write attractive forces, so this student just get 1 point. Okay, one more point is at here. Suggest pH for aqueous sodium hydroxide, anything 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, up to you. Reason it is alkaline is correct, but the marking scheme say base. So what is the difference between alkaline and base? Okay, so we can look at this diagram. What is the difference between base and alkaline? All alkaline are base, but not all base are alkaline. So that's why the answer say base, because just now I just searched whether sodium hydroxide is a base. So the is alkaline. So luckily it is alkaline, but if sodium hydroxide is not alkaline, then base, because not all base are alkaline. So what is the difference between alkaline and base? Base is any metal oxide contain oxide ions, or metal hydroxide contain hydroxide ion. For example, like copper oxide. Alkaline only is soluble in water, and of course sodium hydroxide is soluble in water, and it produces sodium hydroxide ion when dissolved in water. So one is soluble in water, another one is not soluble in water. Let me show you some example. So this is another example that we can see. Is, oh my god, this picture is so big. Okay, for example, base like copper oxide, zinc oxide, or anything like that. Other is metal oxide, but it's not soluble in water. Alkaline is soluble in water. It is sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, but this alkaline also base, you know lah, mathematics, alkaline also is base, okay, because it shows the properties of base. So I just put the diagram at here, somewhere here, or where should I put? Okay, just put here. Okay, moving on. Oh yeah, state the formula ion in sodium hydroxide. So we can see that the question is asking about ion. The question is not asking what element there are in sodium hydroxide, because I know that sodium hydroxide is NaOH, sodium hydroxide. If the question asks what element or what atom is present, so I will say it is sodium, oxygen atom, or oxygen element, and hydrogen. That makes sense. But the question say, ion. Ion means it got charge, correct or not, from ionic bond, and it got charge. That in this bond relationship, sodium hydroxide, we know that sodium got one extra electron already give to hydroxide ion. It's group one mah, hydroxide is negative mah. So when we say about ion means there is charge because sodium already give one electron to hydroxide ion. So it will be sodium positive, OH negative, as you remember in your electrolysis. So the answer will be sodium positive one, hydroxide ions negative one. Not water, this water molecule. So this one is obviously doesn't make sense lah, huh? Because this is water. Yeah, okay, so just be careful when they're talking about ion. What usually happen is if during electrolysis, when sodium is being discharged, sodium receive electron or donate electron. So this one you need to know law. If the question asks are being discharged, so actually sodium is receiving electron and it undergo it receive electron and it undergo reduction if the question asks further, but usually in coordinated sign or in chemistry. The reason is say receive because just now NaOH, when they are married, sodium already give the electron to you. I already give you the one electron. So during electrolysis, let's say I say sodium is being discharged, so sodium need to take back because now you need to separate already. So if I want to separate, so in a how to say, in a logical view, when you are together, I give you, but when I separate, I need to take back. So that's why I say it will be sodium gain back its one electron. It gain back its original electron that he should have. So that's why I say it's received. So it will undergo a process of reduction. Okay. Yeah. So just remember one side lah. Usually I just remember one side, and then another side. It will be usually the opposite, which is the donate, and it should be usually oxidation. So I just remember one side only. The positive one will always receive electron. He just want to get back the electron. If the question asks, explain why sodium must not be added to dilute hydrochloric acid. Yes, it's highly reactive. It can cause explosion. So we don't want anyone to die. So it's like that. Okay, you can write also it is can cause explosion. Also can a few answer here. See, sodium is extracted to molten sodium chloride. So usually I highlight molten because in electrolysis, we follow the ions to be discharged according to the series of reactivity of metals. But because they say molten, so and then molten, then it does not necessarily refer to the series of reactivities, but it can be referred to the thing itself that is being discharged. But if you know electrolysis, usually it is discharged by oxygen, but because you use molten, so it discharges chlorine. If not, probably it will just discharge hydroxide ion, because hydroxide ion is below chlorine, okay? But you say molten, but the question didn't ask, the question got asked, like, oh my god. Okay, so the question asked, so the answer will be chlorine. Why? Because it say molten. If not molten, usually it will be OH ion, which is means it's oxygen. Sodium is an element in period 3 of the periodic table. So in the periodic table, we can see that the period means what? The period means this one, correct? You can see here, this is the period. Period 1, period 2, period 3, period 4, and across this one, we call it group. Group 1, group 2, group 3, group 4. Okay? So, I erase this circle thing first. I don't like to draw my periodic table. Later can use again. I erase it first. Wait. Wait. I cannot undo one. Wait. Wait. Cannot undo already. Okay. Okay. Where was I? So yeah. So period is according. If you go down, group is to the right side horizontally. Let's look at the question. Yeah, actually the student will get correct one. Actually the student is correct. If the student didn't write so many things. The number of outer shell electrons increase and it is less metallic can ready. If the student write like this, the student will get 1 mark. But because if 2 mark then I will give 1 mark. But because it's 1 mark straight away, it will be 0 mark. Huh? As you can see, there's no half mark. The number of outer shell electron increase according to as the period increase, correct, across the period. So it is correct or not? So you can see as it go down, this is only 1 shell. Group period 2 is 2 shell, period 3 is 3 shell, period 4 is 4 shell, and as it go along. And another one is say that and it is less metallic. Oh yeah. Sorry, I say wrong thing already. Okay, they are talking about. I thought they are talking vertical, but actually it's talk. The question is talking about horizontally. Okay, means the outer shell electron increase. So we look at this one. As it go to the right, the outer electron actually increase. So one outer electron, 2 outer electron, 3 outer electron, 4, and this one will be 8 outer electron, for example. So the electron is increased as it's moved to the right. So the student mentioned correct already, okay? Because the student say it moved to the right, it's increased. And it is less metallic to the left. So this is the wrong part. It should be less metallic towards the right. Correct or not? Not to the left, because the student say left, so that is contradicting answer. So the examiner cannot give the full point. We can look
so
at
the right side is more metallic.
Right side is less metallic. Because you see here, you can see alkali earth metal on the left side, then the middle one will be transitional metal. And the non-metal will be this one. I'm a bit colorblind, but I think I'm showing the correct place. So it's moving to the right side where there is less metallic. The left side is less metallic. The left side is the metallic. So because the student say is less metallic to the on the left, so it contradicting answer. So there's no mark. Okay. Show a girl to pump a tire. So of course this girl pump a tire, and after pumping the tire, the pressure inside the tire is greater. Of course it's greater. If lesser, then the tire will go in because you are less pressure. More pressure means the tire become like fat, big. Describe how the distance between molecule in the air different. So very good. Describe the distance between molecule. So your answer should be closer or further apart. So the student straight away answer straight to the point is closer apart. So you straight away get 1 point. The pressure of the air in the bicycle is blah blah blah. The total surface in the area is blah blah blah. Calculate the force. So this is the formula you get correct. After you count, after you do, you get the 75,000. But even if you don't know the formula, you can see this is the formula. Can see or not? N divided by M. So pressure equals to N is the force divided by the M2 is the surface area. So pressure equals to force divided by area. So even if you don't know the formula, the answer already given in the question. So of course sometimes pressure they mention it as Pascal. So usually sometimes they use Pascal, sometimes they use I just put a bracket like that lah, huh? N divided by over M2. So it's the same thing. So if the question may be for coordinated science or for others, for physics, they will say 3 times 10 power of 3 Pascal PA. Then the student will ha 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 ha. Man, if you don't know the formula, of course you cannot do already. But this one is easy lah, they show the unit for you already. Do, you get 75,000 Newton. Very good. Show the structure of a girl's bicycle helmet. Well, girls, this is what? Why boy cannot wear? Why so big? Why? Girls? Maybe girl's head is smaller, is it?
No, because it's already shown that a girl is using a bicycle, man.
Oh, I thought the question is sexist or what? When the girl is cycling, her head gets hot. Yeah, the skin on her head sweat. Suggest how to improve the structure that help the sweat of the head to evaporate. So, of course, the student will get 1 point because it is you say that it helps it to evaporate. And another answer, so these are the answer from the marking scheme. Of course, when you say evaporation, you get 1 point, and then another 2 points, where do I get? So you know lah, as a teacher, usually we just refer to the marking scheme. The student must write something help airflow. So I cannot see something about airflow. And hole allow water to escape. Oh, here got a hole allow water to escape. Oh, so the student get 2 marks. Oh, I didn't see this one. Yeah. Of course, I read fast lah, huh? But I think the when you hand in your IGCSE examination, usually your examiner will read slowly. Okay, they are more professional. And after they read finish, they finish the whole exam paper, they mark, they will send to another guy. So for every exam paper, you got 2 person that actually looking at your exam paper. First one will be marking, the second one will be checking. So it is quite accurate. And that's why there's not much point to re-evaluate your paper, huh? Because usually the chances are, by according to statistics, just 10%, so it doesn't really matter for you to retest unless you are very, very confident that the examiner didn't mark. And one thing not good is it can downgrade your grade. Sometimes B, right, you thought can get A, then after check again, you will get C. So this thing does happen. Suggest a change to the appearance of the helmet that would reduce the amount of radiation absorbed by the helmet. So of course, change it to a brighter light, a lighter light, a shiny, or a white. The answer is actually shiny, white, or light, but you say brighter. So I think brighter can lah. Brighter also mean shiny, is it? Because light color does not absorb as much radiation. Yeah, it does not absorb as much as radiation. Mm-hmm. But it is also more difficult to radiate heat. Let's say the question, let's say I just teach little bit lah. Let's say this is white, this is black. Both is hot. Let's say I put 100 Celsius, the surface lah, the surface. So this is white, this is black. I leave it for 10 minutes. Which one will become colder faster, white or black? So the thing here is dark will radiate heat faster. This one will be faster to become cold. Faster cold. This one will be slower to become cold. If the question asks why, because black radiate heat better. White is of course bright also can radiate heat, but it cannot be compared to matte black. If you want the biggest comparison is shiny white. So sometimes student confused. Of course, this one usually student will get right because student know that okay, I need to buy something white to reflect, I need to wear white shirt. But when the question asks to radiate heat, then this part will be wrong because it will be the opposite. Black actually radiate heat faster than white. Is there any life example? Maybe I can think of is the car radiator. You know the car radiator to put the aircon where the water going to the engine and then come back to the car radiator. So we can see that the car radiator is black color. Probably because it's supposed to be black because black can give up more heat. Your engine is hot, so you don't want to paint it something with white color, so your engine get even hotter. You want the engine to become cold, so it's painted black. The engine is painted black, and the radiator also is painted black. I don't know when got engine painted white color or not. I think so far no lah, huh? Maybe for decoration purpose, but most engine usually is painted black. No point lah, huh? You want heat to be in your engine, later your engine also faster spoil. You know lah, huh? Car, there's a temperature. You don't want the temperature to go up too high, then your car will spoil. Huh? You want the car engine to be in the not too cold and not too hot. But there's another topic that you don't want to go to. But yeah. Show a bell in the level blah blah blah. Huh? This is a bell. 1320 hertz, the speed of the air is 330. Okay, calculate the wavelength. F equals to, so the formula will be V equals to F lambda. Now I also here got the lambda COVID, but just now it's delta mah, delta variation. So now in Malaysia got lambda variation. Okay, so both is these two is correct. So for the working formula, 1 point, the correct answer 1 point. Make sure you write the unit. Of course, this is combined sign, so I don't know, combined sign always they give you the unit. Okay, number 7. During sexual reproduction, flowering plant, both pollination and fertilization take place. Describe the fertilization in a flower. The first point will be keyword of fusion, and the second point will be of fusion combining at the nuclei of a pollen and ovule. So let's see. Ovule is fertilized, new fruit is produced. So of course the marking scheme here mentioned is fusion, joining or combining or of nuclei of pollen. So you see it highlight here. So because there is no this keyword lah, so I cannot give the answer. But although it's still correct, correct or not, fertilization means when the ovule fertilize, a new fruit is produced. So actually it is, the statement is correct, but the answer they want is this one. And this one is not that good statement. Because the question asks why is it fertilized? Because it fertilized. So it is not a good answer, it's giving back the question. Show diagram of wind pollination of flower X and the diagram of the insect pollination. So which one is the insect pollination? Obviously it's the flower Y, because you can see the anther is on the flower and there is a petal for the insect to stand. This one is used by wind because it's outside and there is no place for the insect to stand. So the insect cannot even get the pollen. Describe how anther X adapted for the wind pollination and hanging out so that the pollen can be carried out by the wind. The answer marking thing is say long lah, huh? But I think hanging out also can lah, huh? It's long and long and the pollen. Oh, so one more answer is long, so the student didn't write long, so the student just get one mark. Okay, the anther is long, the anther is hanging out. Give two pieces evidence that show why it's an insect pollination. Large colorful petals. How you know it's colorful? Yeah, the marking scheme say just large petal. Of course we think it's colorful lah, huh? But we don't know because the question is not given, but got two shades lah, huh? It's not given, but still correct lah, huh? And anther and stigma are inside the flower, correct? Okay, yeah, 2 points. Explain why flowering plants are called producer. So this one is they produce their own food, correct? And one more point is because they undergo photosynthesis. So because the student didn't write this word, so the student just get 1 point. Do not feed on others. It depend, correct or not? Some flower feed, some plant feed on other people. So that's why this one, though it's rare lah, but in fact some plant feed on other animal. Producer are first trophic level in the every food chain. Explain why food chain usually have fewer than five trophic level. So this is 2 marks, so that's 2 points. Energy is lost at every trophic level. And you need to explain a bit why. Now, for example, you just say respiration. Okay, energy is lost through respiration, excretion. Did I spell it correct? Excretion and maybe movement, anything lah, growth and so on. So 1 mark. This 2 mark mah. Why you write here 1 point only? But of course you cannot reach high lah, because every level you lost around 25%. So at first it become 100, 100, then become 75, 75, then I don't know lah, your mathematic calculation. The 25% of 75 is maybe 60 plus. Let's say I put 63, then it will go down, and it will be lesser. Okay, it will later become like zero or very less energy. Copper chloride is produced when dilute hydrochloric acid react with copper carbonate. State one substance that react with dilute hydrochloric acid to produce copper chloride. So let's highlight this word, copper chloride with acid. State another substance. So the answer is, you can say copper sulfide or copper oxide. So this one is wrong.
Well, I wrote copper oxide, then I delete, you know.
Yeah lah, you must write, because here already say mah, he used acid and copper carbonate. So if you don't use copper carbonate, you use copper sulfide or you use copper oxide. Okay, you cannot say just use copper part. Oh yeah, so copper cannot, because copper is below hydrogen, correct or not? The reactivity series is below, so it's impossible for copper to kick out hydrogen. Hydrogen can kick out copper, copper cannot kick out hydrogen. Copper is a transitional element, potassium is group 1. State one property of copper that is also in potassium. So what is the property? Maybe high melting point. Okay, so the answer will be in the marking, according to marking, say is solid, high density, malleable, ductile, shiny, good conductor, electric, but no melting point. So this one is JJ.
Boiling point also cannot.
He also didn't say the marking scheme. Good conductor of heat. And he didn't say also, so I just that wrong. State one property of copper compound that is not the property of potassium. So it's more, both is high density, so you should put this one up. This one is because we know that copper is not a metal, copper is a transitional element, so it's more colorful. Copper is more colorful compared to group 1, group 2. All transitional element is more colorful. C, a redox reaction. So the student draw like that, but I prefer to draw the arrow from carbon oxide, copper to copper, carbon to carbon. So we can see that if I can draw this thing out, copper oxide CuO, correct or not? CuO is an ionic bond. If I'm to separate out Cu, just now copper give you the electron, so now copper gain electron. So there will be so this copper gain electron, so this will be the, yeah, okay, so gain electron will be a reduction. So I just write here lah, reduction, oxidation. And also one more thing is reduction because it from Cu 2 plus become Cu. So that is the oxidation number is decreased, showing it's a reduction as well. So either you can use this one, oxidation number decrease, or you can say that it gain electron, or another definition is it lose oxygen. Copper lost oxygen. So when it's lost oxygen, it's also a reduction. Yeah, so there's a three definition, and then the oxidation will be the opposite part. Explain in detail why is it a redox reaction. So we already explained. Oh, no, a redox reaction means when both undergo oxidation and reduction, correct? Okay, so this one you will get 1 point. Oxidation agent are reduced, and reduction agent are oxidized. What? Okay, let's read this whole sentence and see whether it makes sense or not. Oxidation agent are reduced and reduction agent are oxidized. Actually, this whole sentence, it does not make sense, and it shows the student still haven't understand the meaning of oxidation agent. The meaning of oxidation agent is to oxidize other substance. So oxidation agent will be, if the student say oxidation agent will be the carbon, okay, correct. Okay, oxidizing agent, which is actually this part, correct? This part, the copper oxide. Because oxidizing agent are being reduced, correct. This statement is correct. Okay, oxidation agent, which is the copper oxide, are being reduced, and reduction agent are being oxidized. But the better meaning for oxidized agent is oxidized agent is the thing to oxidize, the agent to oxidize. That's why it's copper oxide to oxidize, and reducing agent is the substance to reduce. So this thing actually to reduce, but we can explain in a better way lah. We explain in a better way. So of course this one the student will get here 1 mark. So it's a 3 mark. So how to get this another 2 mark? So we can say that copper oxide is reduced. Okay, copper oxide is reduced, 1 point. Another, we can say that copper oxide lost its oxygen.
Then can I say carbon is oxidizer?
You can say this one, carbon is oxidized, yes. Oxidized. Or you can say carbon gain oxygen. Okay, there's these two answers. But I don't know why the marking scheme didn't say other answer. For example, like actually copper is gaining electron, copper is also losing oxygen. There's another two definition, but it's not in the marking scheme. Probably because this is a combined science, this is not a chemistry subject. So just remember lah, I also need to think. Means that I need to write the what is being reduced, and I need to write the more simple definition, okay? We want to talk about the oxygen rather than gaining electron or decrease in oxidation number, huh? Because this is a combined sign, so I also need to remember that. Later I confused. Okay, last question D. Figures show the arrangement of copper atom and zinc atom. So this is what? We can see there is copper and atom. Probably this is an alloy, a mixture of zinc and copper to make it stronger. Circle the thing to describe the brass. So the answer will be alloy and mixture. So there's two answers here. Alloy and mixture. So this one, the student didn't get the mark lah because it is two. So it will be stronger, it's more difficult, it will be stronger, so that the atom is more difficult to slide with one another. Like, if the question gonna ask lah, why is it stronger? Because there's a different other element that's being put in, so that the between the particle is more difficult for the particle to slide. So you get like aluminium or a stronger steel. Steel is not iron ah, steel is alloy. Okay, iron is iron, steel is steel, but you know lah, other people they will confuse iron and steel, so it's a different thing. Okay, so I teach until here, and I see you next time, and bye bye.
Okay, thank you, bye bye.
Thank you, bye bye.